Guys, this is Mr. Josh CJ, and this is your preview to Sheffield United versus Manchester United in the Premier League at Bramall Lane. Kickoff time in the UK, 8 p.m, live on Sky Sports. A late Saturday night game, which that's a very interesting time, but is what it is. Obviously, before Sheffield United and Manchester United, you have Chelsea versus Arsenal, which I'm very much looking forward to that one as well. So that's going to be a fun Saturday evening. And then Saturday afternoon, I'm going to watch my favourite non-league team, Chippenham Town FC. So it's going to be a very busy Saturday for me, footballing-wise. So in goal, I'll play Andre Onana there. Right-back, Diego Dalo. Centre-backs, Victor Lindelof. Rafael Varane, even though Varane has not looked the best recently, but he's still a fantastic defender. Then, in the left-back position, I'll play, well, recently, Amrabat's seen in the left-back position, but he played a more midfield role in the last game. But, yeah, I would put in Amrabat in the left-back position. And then, central defence had failed Casemiro. Now, there were rumours that Casemiro was injured for this one because he went off injured for Brazil. But, thankfully, it was only a precaution and he is fit and ready to start for us. So, yeah, I'll start Casemiro. Then, in the midfield, I'll go for Mason Mount. I believe he will start. And then, obviously, it will be Ericsson sometimes starts games, so yeah, it could be Ericsson in the midfield, so I think he'll come on as a substitute. Yep. Bruno Fernandes, Garnacho, Marcus Rashford, and Rasmus Højlund. Yes, that's the lineup I'll go with now. Bruno, playing Mason Mount and Bruno in the midfield together just doesn't work. But recently, Erik ten Hag has been playing Bruno Fernandes on the right wing, which means Mount has had more freedom in midfield. I don't think Bruno Fernandes is a winger, though. He is much more of an attacking midfielder. I mean, Casemiro's not looked great recently, but going forwards, getting into the penalty box now, he's seen phenomenal Casemiro, so there are some positives in him. But Rasmus Højlund, I'm expecting him to do very well. And he scored for Denmark as well, so that'd be a huge confidence boost for Rasmus Højlund. I'm just thankful the international break is over now, because I really miss the Premier League. But saying that, it's a very good win for England, so last night against Italy. I thought Harry Kane was absolutely superb. I'll be back over on my football channel this weekend doing the match reaction to Chelsea versus Arsenal. Yep, so I'll link my football channel in the description of this video. So if you wish to subscribe, you can do. And please subscribe to this channel if you're a Manchester United fan. You want to see many more Manchester United videos. And also, I did a unboxing video, this limited edition Spider-Man 2 PlayStation 5 console. The views are going absolutely insane for that, honestly. And as you know, yesterday I hit 700 subscribers, which, again, I can't thank you all enough. But, yeah, I'm really looking forward to this game. Hopefully, we can win for a second game in a row, because we're yet to win back-to-back games this season, which, that is nowhere near good enough for a club like Manchester United. Not able to win back-to-back games, a club of this magnitude. It's just, it's shocking, it really is. But they won't be all going for it, because Sheffield United will be looking for their first win of the season. And I will be absolutely furious if Manchester United lose this one. We cannot lose this one. It'd be totally unacceptable if we lose this match. Honestly, it'd be absolutely terrible. Yeah, so really got to step it up. And also, tomorrow, you see, is my birthday. And That's when Sir Jim Ratcliffe and the Glazers are going to meet. And it would be on my birthday, wouldn't it? But I'm not expecting to hear any news until Friday morning, to be honest, when the New York Stock Exchange is announced. But the shares have dropped massively in the New York Stock Exchange market since Sheikh Jassim has withdrawn his offer. So, yeah, not looking good, is it? But we'll wait and see what happens on this one. I'm just focused on the match, to be honest. I just hope we can get the job done, that all this business, what's going on off the pitch, is not going to have a psychological effect on the players, because it really could do. I'm not going to lie, it really could have a psychological impact on these players, which the players have just got to do their job. It's as simple as that. You're professional enough to do your job. You bloody get on and do your job. It's as simple as that. No messing around. No bullshitting around. Just do your job. Yep. But Sheffield United, like, I don't know much really about their players, because I haven't watched them play very often. But all I know is that Sheffield United and Bournemouth are the only two teams who are yet to win this season. Because obviously Burnley have won the game, Luton have won the game, so yeah, Sheffield United and Bournemouth are the only two who have not won yet. But more than likely, Manchester United come to Sheffield, Manchester United will possibly roll over, and Sheffield United get their first win of the season, which, that just is sod's law, it really would. But I wouldn't put it past them, like how Manchester United are in this season. But I'm hopeful we can surely get a job done against Sheffield United. If we don't, something is seriously wrong in this football club. Well, we know something is seriously wrong already. Off the pitch, so much drama is happening. But on the pitch, we just need to stay focused, carry on supporting the team. But yeah, it's all going to kick off, honestly, with like the Glazers staying. Will fans now start to boycott matches? This is the thing. Will fans up the tempo thinking, do you know what? We're not going to fucking travel up to these games. We're going to just stay at home and not go to the stadium. I mean, then that's the only way hurting the Glazers in their pocket. But I don't know. I really don't know what the answer is. All I know is that Rasmus Højlund is playing brilliantly, you know, and Martial would more than likely come on as a sub. But yeah, Casemiro, like I said, he's not looked great recently, but going forward in that, he is still absolutely superb in the dangerous areas. Mason Mount, I believe it's only a matter of time before he scores his first goal. Honestly, like I said, he still hasn't won me over yet, but in that midfield area where Bruno's in on the right wing, he has been playing well. So, yeah, fair play. Credit where it's due. He just needs to score his first goal, really. But, yeah, he needs to stick at it. He cannot afford to go off the boil. Otherwise, Mason Mount, he'll be under a lot of criticism, in my opinion. But hopefully he can carry on doing a decent job. And, obviously, Bruno on that right wing, I thought he's very poor against Brentford on the right wing, but once he's put back in his usual midfield position, I thought he's brilliant. Garnacho, obviously, he's like a super sub, but I want him to be starting more matches. Rashford to England, what a goal that was. He needs to start doing that for Manchester United. But in all seriousness, that was Jude Bellingham who did all the hard work to set him up last night, but he can do that more often at Manchester United. That'd be wonderful, Marcus. You really would get fans back on your side. But yep, Premier League football is back. I cannot wait. Join me late Saturday evening for a match reaction. Sunday for player ratings. Sunday is going to be a busy day, because not only will I have my player ratings uploads, I have my F1 race reviews that are below. So yeah, as I said, comment your thoughts down below. I will always reply. Support on this channel recently has been absolutely amazing. I cannot thank you enough, honestly. And to think I'm less than 300 away now from that 1k is absolutely unreal. It really is. As I said before, link to my football channel in the description of this video. Come on board to this channel and my football channel if you wish. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.